This video is to just provide some ideas and suggestions for students that are undertaking study and assessment. As you may or may not be aware by watching this video, there are students now coming up to their end of year examination, and this in itself can be a very busy and stressful year. I thought I'd provide some advice from my own experience from being someone that had studied, and I guess that things might have changed a little bit since when I studied in the 90s to what the study is now for students. But the main thing is to not be too hard on yourself. And of course, the famous word that goes around academic circles or around students, as far as I remember in my day, and it still probably still applies now, is the word procrastination. The best thing to do is to have study periods where you can actually provide some time and discipline to your studies. So this might mean that you choose a time of day that you can actually do some study and to put in some hours of work. This might be a couple of hours, or it might be 4 or 5 hours a day, or whatever that suits your needs. And to balance this with some sort of exercise or some sort of healthy diet and some sort of activity that gives you a reward for the hard work and effort that you actually undertake. It can be very, very testing for students at this time of the year because there is a lot of pressure. There's a lot of pressure not only on performance in an academic sense, but also in performance in the sense of what is going to be the result of after the examination period, in terms of is there going to be employment, is there going to be opportunities that become possible, and so forth. I would encourage any student that is watching this video to first of all look at ways of networking and look at ways to improve your chances of being able to enter the labour market. And this may simply include even setting up a LinkedIn profile, or to even set up some sort of a online means of being able to get yourself out there, to be able to get yourself out into the wider community, and to be able to network. LinkedIn is a very effective tool in this means. I use LinkedIn myself, and I know many other people that actually use it, and it's a good means to be able to write blogs and to be able to update your academic credentials as well as your employment skills and abilities. And this is something that can help to prepare you for when you enter the labour market. But more importantly, at this time of the year, it's always a good idea to be able to look after yourself, because it's yourself that's first and foremost in this busy period, and you have to be able to function, and you have to be able to eat and look after yourself so that you can get the maximum performance not only in yourself but in the examinations and assessment that you have to undertake. First of all, as I've suggested, is to actually get out there and get involved with some activities to get yourself away from just studying all the time. I think too often students can be in a situation where there's too much pressure on academic performance and ability, and this needs to be balanced with some sort of physical and regular exercise and healthy diet. So, reward yourself, guys and girls, after your assessment. If you've done something, or if you've spent 3 hours, you've self-disciplined yourself to do some study, do something that will give you a sense of satisfaction and achievement, and for rewarding your efforts and your hard work in doing some study and preparation for your assessment. This might even be a favourite food, it might be a walk, it might be going to the beach, it might be catching up with your girlfriend, it might be a whole host of activities. I'd also encourage, and I've encouraged many students that I come into contact with, if you want to do something over the Christmas period, over the period where there's not a lot to do, why not look at somewhere like New Zealand? New Zealand offers a lot of outdoor activities. You can do heaps of things over there, like board riding and going on hikes. You can also do skydiving. You can do mountain climbing, all those sorts of things. I'd encourage students to actually have a look at New Zealand as an outdoor adventure activity place, because, why not reward yourselves after the hard work that you've undertaken and the dedication that you've done. I mean, for any student, I acknowledge the hard work that you're undertaking, and as someone that is in the academic sector, I really wish you all the best for your upcoming assessment and exams, and I hope that things do work out in your favour, and you're able to get the results you want and to be able to go in the direction that you're seeking. So thanks very much for watching this video.